Now this thing is just a total powerhouse.
Da, 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 da.
Well, here's an update. Now, to those of you who didn't see my other video that I made a couple days where I unboxed and went through the setup process and showed a couple initial test shots with this, I want to reinstate that this is not the full in-depth review. I've only had this for a couple days, but the initial test footage that I was trying to do with this setup, which you'll see right here, my original goal was to have this be able to balance all that. And so I went through the initial test shots because the motors can handle it. It is indeed just under the weight capacity. We all saw those test shots and they were just completely unusable, terrible wobble. And yeah, so this is an update. I have spent countless hours this weekend figuring this thing out, what works, what doesn't work. And I wanted to share my findings with you guys. First off, I watched all the videos that existed out there, troubleshooting this, other pocket owners, how to get people, how people got it to work. And some people got pretty successful. Some people kind of just dealt with it and showed the best way to deal with it. For example, you can go in POV mode and flip this thing all the way upside down and then just flip all the footage in post. In my test, that did work a little bit, but I wasn't about to shoot upside down for like every gimbal shoot going forward and flip. If that was the only thing that worked, then honestly, I'd probably suck it up and do it because again, I want one of these rigs to work, but that was just not ideal for me. I really spent a good amount of time making sure that thing was perfectly balanced and I got it to the point where it was perfectly balanced. While the motors were off, I could put it in any position and it wouldn't move and it would stay, had some counterweights on the side. In the past, when I've tested gimbals, how you know they don't, your rig is not going to work on it, is if the motors are giving out constantly. And what I mean by give out is mess with the pan or roll axis too much and you know the motors just kind of go limp and you have to like reboot it. That's when you know you're at weight capacity, when you're putting too much like G-forces or whatever down on it. The motors never gave out. And that's how I know for a fact, and for anyone who says, oh, the motors aren't strong enough for that rig or anything, dead wrong. It's not that at all. It's not about the weight. It's not about how big it is. The secret sauce is it's literally the dimensions of it. You see, the biggest issue between the Blackmagic Pocket 4K and 6K and what makes it stand out amongst almost any other camera out there, it is so wide. Companies have literally made base plates that like extend or like push it off to the side specifically for the Pocket series of cameras. And it has become the most frustrating part of the Pocket series. Blackmagic is known for making just abnormally shaped cameras. So I narrowed the issue down to 2 points. It's not this motor, not this motor. It all has to do up here. And again, it's not this motor's strength per se. What I believe it is, so right under here, this little thing that slides out here. I'm gonna show you on my FireTech because there's nothing rigged up to here. The issue is that again, because the Pocket series of cameras is so wide, this little thing right here that you have to slide in and out, depending on, again, how wide your camera is and where the center of balance is. Yeah, Pocket series cameras, we all know this, all the way to the edge, right? Well, that's what I had to do on there. And again, it's solid metal, didn't feel wobbly at all. But I really think the issue is because with the Pocket 6K, I have the tilt-a-cage on. And so to get it to literally just barely fit in there, I have to go all the way out to the edge. And that's where I think Zhiyun didn't have it rated for that sort of weight all the way out here. I have tested every single mode, every single configuration while maintaining the same width of setup. And I just think it is literally scientifically, mathematically impossible for however this is built to go all the way to the edge and still support 12 to 14 pounds without having any sort of wobble. Now, the second part to that is you'll notice on this one, it goes camera, half camera cage, and then directly base plate. On that, I have camera, camera cage, and then it goes to the 15 millimeter attachment, which is about this tall. And then we have the other base plate below that. And so it's not necessarily just how tall it is. I mean, I still have the handle on top, but if you look at a lot of other Crane 3S gimbal people, the C200s, 300s, 500s, they kept the viewfinders and the monitors on top. So it's not necessarily the height, but I think the issue is that it has about this much height where there's no real weight. And then the weight is all—it's essentially top heavy. And so I think if I took off that whole rail system, that would work. And that's essentially what I've done here. So this, yes, it weighs less because I don't have the V-mount battery on the back. But again, both setups are under the weight capacity itself. But I fixed the two issues here. I no longer have to go all the way to the outer edge on this slide here because I'm using a half cage, so that way I can put the right side of the Pocket 4K all the way up to the right. And again, by the way, Pocket 4K 6K doesn't matter. This could be the 6K. There's no width difference between the two. It's just the 4K I have in the half cage. So the half cage allows me to make that slide in just a little bit. It's still pretty far out there, but it's not all the way out. And then the weight is all close to the bottom of the base plate here. Now, what I thought was a genius move here is, I don't know if you can see, is this little bar right here. This is actually from the FiuTech. It was a little piece. But if you look at big gimbals like the Movi or the Ronin, because they have such camera packages, there's so much pressure on these base plates. So what they do is they have an extra little bar that goes up top and you connect to the top of the camera. And that way it's kind of all packaged together in here. So no matter when you're doing rolls or if you go all the way upside down, it's still going to have some support right here holding it up rather than just all the pressure being on the base plate. And so I tried that using this setup and using this. Unfortunately, I still got wobble and I tested on this and it's not necessary. So if you have this setup, I would try those two things first. But the reason I like it again is so when I'm doing rolls on this or just in general, if I attach this to the car, it's a multiple point of contact. So now for whatever reason, if this base plate like broke or slip off or anything, this isn't the strongest thing in the world, but it's still probably gonna keep it on there. You also notice some counterweights right here. This isn't a necessity as well, only in my setup, just because this lens is super heavy and because there's literally nothing behind the camera. So I don't have a V-mount back here or anything. Now doing those two things, sliding it in a little bit more and keeping the weight as low and as close to that base plate as possible, this thing now works perfectly like a gimbal, and I do not have to spend an hour getting it absolutely perfectly balanced. If you look at this, I had it pretty close before, but that's not closely balanced, right? I actually put my 45 millimeter lens on here because I needed the 15 on here. But watch this, if I turn on the gimbal, boom. And by the way, I don't even have the battery pack turned on yet. This is still no battery pack. It has no issues, no wobble. Yeah, I'm on medium right now. Now, the other awesome thing about this is obviously this helps get the full strength out of the motors, but I also plugged in my second D-tap to DC power, and now this is also running my camera. So again, I don't need a V-mount plate, but I still have a V-mount type battery. The full review, I will have how long this thing actually powers both the gimbal and the Pocket 4K, but I can tell you that it's gonna be a decent while because I did some initial tests. It's definitely more than the 50 minutes or so that your internal battery is gonna get, so that's a plus. You'll also notice that I took off the tall stick. Honestly, it ended up just getting in my way for the movements that I was doing, as well as when I was sitting it down. It didn't fall over, but it definitely, I mean, that's just physics, right? It definitely would have fallen over easier than this. I feel way more comfortable stepping away from this for a couple minutes than I did with it all the way up top. This shaved a ton of weight, and again, this thing, no wobble whatsoever. Perfectly smooth. Just to prove it, I'll even record. No extra post. This is all 24 FPS. This is the 45 millimeter, so technically it should show even more imperfections. And you can see I'm in the low mode, which everyone feared. And, you know, I feel like I'm sweeping a rug or something. But you can see there's absolutely no wobble. And this thing now is the gimbal that I wish it'd be. Now again, I know this video is kind of long. Again, this video is kind of intended for the people who have been having issues with heavier payloads and specifically Blackmagic pocket cameras on the Crane 3S gimbal. So again, the full review will be much more test footage and pretty B-roll and showing off all the features. By the way, I got the whole wireless kit, came a lot earlier than expected. So now this thing is just a total powerhouse of a gimbal. And you can see that it's crazy. I mean, no wobble. That is a 2.5+ pound lens on the front of a half cage pocket 4K. And I mean, this is on medium. Anyway, that's it for the now, guys. Leave comments down below if you're still having issues, if you try any of these things out. Again, there's two things. Keep that slide as close in as possible and maybe go to a half cage or no cage if you can. This half cage is by Condor Blue. It's awesome. I'll link it in the description below. I'll link the weights. I'll try to find this as a standalone plate as well. So check the description if you want to pick up some of these accessories. But yeah, leave me any questions down in the comments and I'll see you guys in the next video.